In this video, we're going to show you how to perform various different types of validations in Testim. Now, if you're familiar with automation, you know that almost every automated test has some sort of validation or perhaps multiple validations. No different in Testim when we provide a number of different ways to do that. Obviously, we're assuming that you already have an account, you logged into Testim, and hopefully you've created some tests. So let's get started. So as we can see here, we actually have a particular test that we've started. What I'm going to do is on the right-hand side for the test step here, I'm going to hover over and it says test and predefined steps. I'm going to click on that. And if we expand validations, we can see there's a ton of different things we can validate. We can validate the downloading of a PDF or a text file. We can do a CLI validation. We can validate an element is visible, not visible. We can validate emails. We're going to actually go ahead and select this particular property, CSS. Okay, so let's go ahead and restart recording our test. And now let's go over here and click on validations, and we're going to do CSS property. We're going to click select destination. And it is background is what we're interested in. And the expected value is going to be this. Also, as a best practice from actually when you're developing test cases, it's always good to override the timeout. The default is 30 seconds, but I wanted to change it to a few seconds. So if the test fails, I'm not waiting for the test to complete because it'll keep retrying up to 30 seconds before it fails. And we can see the test completed successfully. Great, right? If you wondered how I was able to get that information, if you were to right click on this and click inspect, and we can see that the background is here and the color is here, and I believe we selected background, okay? So we can see that the background was this value, right? So that's an example of doing a CSS validation. Let's look at another example. Let's look at a data-driven type of an evaluation example. So in this example, I have actually passed in test data. So we're going to basically, this is performing a login test, and we're validating that the text at login is hello John. So I'm going to copy this variable, my user. We're going to generate an email address, set password, click logon. So let's actually go ahead and run this test. Okay. And it's going to generate a random email. It's going to log in. And now we want to perform a validation that hello John is on the screen. So one thing we can do if we click on test and predefined steps, under actions we can pick on extract value step. This is going to extract data from the page. And if we go in here, this value we want to say is logged in user. Okay. So the next thing we want to do is we want to validate it against what we passed in our data-driven test. Okay. So now what we can do is we can also do a validation of text. We're going to validate element text. Again, this is contextual. I want to click on that on the screen. If I come back down here and, here it's hello John. I want to put this, which of course we know that this is the variable that's holding the string hello John, right? So now let's go ahead and run this. And it's going to do the login again. And it's going to perform a basic validation. And we can see that the test completed successfully. So this is yet another type of validation to perform. And again, this was a data-driven sort of an example, okay? So now if we look at this is yet another one, right? This is where we're extracting data. We talked about this a little bit, but here, again, we can do this. So let's see this. Okay, so let's go ahead and run this test. And again, this is going to perform a basic login. And of course, now we're logged in. Okay. So now what we can do in this example is we can say, okay, I want to do also an extract value step. I want to click on this. So I'm going to say this is current user. Okay. And then what I could do here is I could actually have another, I could have a custom validation. Okay. Custom validation. We'll put that as an example. I'm not going to create a shared step right now. And now what I can say is if, sorry, what was the name of my user? My name of my user was current user. So if current user equals logged in user, and as you notice here, we have complete access to VSS code. I can say login validation passed. And I'm going to do this because I don't like typing that much. And we'll do false. The one final thing I wanted to check was we extracted the value current user. Okay. And let's do this. And if we go in here, right, hello John. Okay. So let's go ahead and actually run this. And we can see that the test completed successfully. Now, what I probably could have done, which would have been more of a best practice, is instead of hard coding this variable in here, I could have passed in a parameter here. So if I wanted to do that, I don't know if this test has test data. It does not. So we could actually do that if we wanted to do that. But hopefully this gave you a nice overview of validations and different types of validations that you can do. Feel free to go out to the website or reach out to us if you have additional questions.